Yo, what's going on, guys? This video we're going to be doing color from HackMyVM. This is Boxer with about solid medium. And yeah, let's get on to the video. So I'm going to start with my terminals here. I'm going to start running gain ads cover my star 10.0.0.1/24/IT0. In this video, you can be the box 10.0.137 or 134 actually. So do MMISSC for default scripts. My sensitive enumeration was kind of ports and IP. Doing this, I'll do my verbose. Look at the ports. I did port 8 open for HTTP and also port 2 went open for FTP. Some servers in port 80. Look at this. Where do you get the website has been seized? The domain has been seized by the FBI. So we do have an image here. So I'm going to control your source code. It doesn't seem like anything. So I'm going to start by doing some more manual enumeration, running GoBuster. So to GoBuster to remote my students and the IP address. We'll do my stubby for user share world list or buster. Your buster directory list, you put the medium.txt, which looks as HTML, txt, and also php. Looking back at that map scan, we do have port 2 and open for FTP. We do have anonymous enabled. We do have first, second, a secret JPEG, and also a third. I'm guessing this is going to be Stego since we do have the secret. And also is an image, right? It did log in as FTP. Also do have port 22, which is filtered for SSH, and also port 8 for HTTP. And this is running Apache. But here, I'm starting by using wget. We'll do wget minus r for FTP. Because I do want to get all the files and all the hidden directories under FTP, right? So do 10.0.0.134. We'll do this on port 21. We'll CD into 10.0.0.134. Now we do have all the files, right? So this is recursive, so it does do for directories and also any other files that we do have on the FTP, right? I'm just going to file like a command against secret. We do see that this is an image here. We do have a JPEG image data. I am going to copy this secret. We'll copy this back. Run the file command. We'll just do the same thing, right? I also like checking for running xftool against secret JPEG since it does have, or the image, right? Since it does, someone can actually put a comment under the secret JPEG. So usually under here, you'll see like a slash comment. They can use like the XF tool to put a comment, and maybe that's information that we do need. Next thing I'm gonna start by checking is for, since I do think there's a Stego under here, I'm gonna use Stego hide. We'll extract the information. We'll do minus SF for secret. It just tells us to enter your passphrase, and we don't have the passphrase. So I'm starting by using Stegseek. Stegseek is allows us to specify an image followed by the word list. So in this case, we have secret for user share word list rockyou.txt, and it did find that passphrase as never mind. So now we can extract the data again. Did output it to more underscore secret.txt. We do have some base 85 here. So I'm going to copy this. I'm just going to go to CyberChef. I'll do this for 85. We'll go to from 85. And here we do have a little message for us, right? So here we do have a message. Like at the bottom, we do have some credentials here, which is going to be for pink. Followed by the password. So I'm just gonna copy the password. Looking back at that map scan, we do have port 22, which is filtered for SSH. So I'm gonna be trying the credentials for port 21 open for FTP. So we do have FTP 10.0.0.134. We'll do this for pink. We'll do control. We do else mycelia. And here we do have four users. So we have users green, pink, purple, and red. So I'm CD into pink since I am under that user. So do else mentally. We do have a DOS SSH and also this node.txt. So I'm just gonna get this node.txt. I do want to cat this node.txt. It doesn't seem like we're doing anything under here. So I'm just gonna run node against this or file against node. It is ASCII text, right? So it doesn't seem like we're doing anything under there. I'm also gonna CD into DOS SSH. The reason for this, I do want to see I can put this node.txt. We do have the transfer complete, so that means I can start by basically getting my private key, also my public key, and putting the public key under this, under the SSH, right? So see, we can SSH into pink. So do SSH keygen. So I'm copy from slash root SSH, ID underscore it to its directory, and also this dot pub. The reason I have it under this path under here is because I did FTP using under this path, right, which is this path right here. And using this path, I do need to be in the same directory, so I can just put the authorization keys under this DOS SSH. So I'm just going to move this ID underscore c.pub to authorize underscore keys. Now I do have this authorization score keys. So do Control L. We'll put this authorization score keys. We'll do CH minus 600 for authorization score keys. So now we do have the permissions for authorization score keys. Looking back, we do have port 22, which is filtered for SSH. So there's two ways we can do this. So we can do this through IPv4 or also through IPv6. I'm going to take the easy route and just do IPv4. IPv4 just is port knocking, right? Port knocking basically just allows you to do a sequence of numbers. It does require a sequence of numbers, which you can just use netcat, or you can use the binary for knock. I'm going to be using the binary for knock, so I can just specify this quickly for 1127, 1039, and also 1081, right? So this is going to be for the sequence. Usually the sequence to close the port backup is going to be backwards. It's going to be 1081, 1039, and also 1127. So I'll start by doing that. So I'm using knock. We'll specify knock. Let's specify 1127. So I'm guessing it's going to be going in order for 1127, 1039, also for 1081. So do mmap. We'll scan up ports on 10.0.0.134. We'll do minus V, and you'll see that port 22 is open for SSH. So I'm SSH into pink. We'll do at 10.0.0.134. We'll do minus I for ID underscore SA. Runs one more time. We do yes. Web terminals, we do ID. And now we're under pink. So I'm going to start by running this sudo minus L. We do have the password for pink, so I'm just going to copy and paste. It didn't seem like you could run sudo on color, right? Under here, we do have this node.txt. Didn't seem like we did anything. I'm going to start by doing some under narration under some directories. So I'll do under slash op. We'll go under slash var. We'll go into backups. One thing under backups. I'll cd into var dum dum dum. And here, we do have a HTML. So we do have a directory as HTML, of course, which is the document root. We do have this running as dum 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 data, so any files that I do put in there, it's going to be run as dum 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 data. So I'll cd into HTML. I'm going to be putting a PHP shell.php. I'll just go to GitHub. So go to reverse shell.php, go to raw data. Or I'll see if we have wget. We do have wget, so I'm just going to wget this PHP shell.php. I'm just going to nano PHP shell.php. We'll change the IP address. It'll be for 10.0.0.70. And we'll do this for port 9001. So I'll do Control Shift O. So do our wrap. Let me zoom in. Netcat minus LVP on 9001. So we did have this under document root. So under document root, we can just do forward slash php shell.php. Looking back, we do ID. And now under dum data. So I'm going to start running a bin slash bash minus I. Clear my terminals here. I'm going to start by exporting my term. As you go to xterm, we cd back, we do ID, and we're under dum data. So I'm going to start running a sudo myself. Under here, we can run a user bin vim against green. So I'm just going to go to gtfull bins. I'll do this for vim. So here we can break out of restricted environments using minus C to execute command. So basically specifying an argument for like the colon, specify, just run a bin slash sh, right? So I'm just going to copy that. So do sudo minus U, run this as green. For we do have this for user bin vim. Specify minus C. We do ID, and now we're green. So I can run a bin slash bash minus I, cd back. We do ID. And now under green. Under here, we do have a node.txt. So I'm going to see cat to node.txt. Seems like we've been working well lately. And basically, if we, I'm guessing it's talking about this test underscore four underscore green. If we pass, then I'll give you the password for purple, right? Under here, since we don't have a percentage shell in the box, I'm mkdir to .ssh. I'll create a directory for green here. I'll do mkdir for green, cd to green, we'll do ssh kgen. Copy from slash root.ssh, id underscore to this directory. We'll do the same thing for .pub. So I can do python3 minus m http.server and port 8081. Or I'll just move this ID underscore say dot pub to authorize underscore keys so I don't change the file name on the box, right? So now we do have this authorize underscore keys. So dwget http 10.0.0.70 import 8.8.1 for the authorize underscore keys. We'll do chmod 600 for authorize underscore keys. Now we do have that private key for the public key. So I'm SSH into green. We do at 10.0.0.134 minus I for ID underscore same. We do ID and down under green. So I'm server running a sudo minus L. Doesn't seem like we did the password for green, so I'm running as nicely. Under here, we do have a binary as test underscore for green. So I'm just going to run this, see what this is. I'm just going to put like a random number 4 or 5. I'm going to put for 10. And doesn't seem like we can guess that number, right? It is possible to guess this number, which I'm going to be doing using Python. You can use Bash, but that's going to be way too slow. So Python is faster than Bash, right? So I'll be using Python for this. I do want to transfer this binary so I can actually put this into Ghidra. I believe this binary is using a function here to generate that number, right? So I'll do Python 3 minus M HTTP dot server. I'll just do this on port 8.8.1. I do want to put this into a proper directory here, so I'll just put this into bin. I'll cd into bin, we'll wget HTTP 10.0.0.134, we'll do this on port 8.8.1. We'll begin this test underscore for green, right? So do chmod plus 6 for green. You do see that I do get the same output, right? So I'm going to start by going to the GitHub for Ghidra. So here we do have the repository here. I'll just go to releases here. And we'll go to the assets. So for some reason, it doesn't seem like this is going to load. So I do have the .zip. I'm just going to go to my Windows machine. So I am going to be blurring this out since this is my real Windows machine. Under here, we do have this for, I believe, open. Let's see what I have under here. So I do have this for Ghidra. So I'm just going to start a Python server on my Windows machine. So we'll do py. Since I don't have Python 3, we'll do py minus m http.server. We'll do some port 8.8.1. Okay. So I'll do wget http 10.0.0.243, I believe. That's my Windows machine. Port 8.8.1. And yeah, so we do have this .zip. We can unzip this using unzip. I'll clear my terminals here. I'll use unzip for Ghidra. The next thing that we do need is actually going to be for, if we look back at the GitHub repository, we're going to be needing this, let's go back, JDK, I believe. We do need to install JDK, which also doesn't let us view the archives for this. Let me open my CMD. We do have this form. I'll run an LSMSLA against open. I'll do the same thing, start my Python server. So do wget. Instead of Ghidra, we'll do this form. Open JDK. I believe this is a tar.gc file. Yeah, it is a tar.gc file. So we can do tar minus xvf against open. So basically JDK is going to allow us to run Ghidra. And the reason I do want to run Ghidra is because I do want to find the function of basically what the sequence of numbers is, right? And then also does allow us to view the source code. So that's going to help us guess a sequence of numbers, right? Because it can be, this sequence of numbers can be from 1 to 500, right? Or, but I don't want to try this manually, so I do want to make a sequence of numbers in Python to guess that for us. So I'll cd into Ghidra. We do have this for what runs for Ghidra run. So now we can start up Ghidra. So let's open up Ghidra. We'll go to file, we'll go to open. I guess we have to put a project in there, right? Or binary, I believe. I guess we can put this form. Would have been. This work. There we go. So we can go to OK. So now we can just like Ghidra import it. Go to yes. Analyze. OK. And here we do want to inspect the functions here. So we can go to functions. We'll go to the main function here. So we have a Lucas function, the main function. So I guess these are the main two functions that we do have. And here you'll see that we do have the source code here. I am going to look for that function that we were talking about. So we do have this ivar1, which is going to be called a rand. Rand is going to determine from one. It's basically just going from 1 to 1 million that we do have here. So now we do know the sequence of numbers, which is going to be from 1 to 1 million. We can create a Python script to generate and basically just get this. It's not going to go in order. Generate a sequence of numbers from 1 to 1 million. And if it does guess it, then we can basically just print it out, right? And we do have the pass. Here we can also see that we have the puts. So this is after they put in the right number and just have the correct here, right? So we do want to check for the standard output to check if it does have correct. If it does have correct, then we can print out that password, right? So start by doing this within Python, right? So I'm going to go back into green. I'm just going to nano into run.py. I'll just run this in user bin Python 3 since it is going to be faster. So I'm going to start by importing subprocess. I'm also going to import random. Random is going to allow us to view, just create a random int. We can use the random int. So it's going to be random.randint, which is going to generate that sequence of numbers, which in this case we have 1 million. So it's going to be from 1 to 1 million to guess that right number. So here I'm going to start by creating a while true loop. While true allows us to also just create a loop. We're going to create a random loop. And we'll create our n is equal to random. Remember that function I was talking about, which can be for that rand int. We did have 1 to 1 million. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We want to start by creating a process. So we'll use that sub process, a dot run. So we can run that process. We can specify some brackets here. I'll just put program here for now, right? I'll just specify the program so we can just copy and paste later on the program name, right? We'll input, it's going to go to string, specify n, we'll specify the text for true. So next we can specify the text to true. We can also capture the output. I'm not sure if I should capture the output. I think it would be best to capture the output since we're going to check to, so we can actually print out the string, right? So just capture the output. We'll set this to true actually. I was going to set it to false, but it would make of course more sense to put it true. So next, we did have this to correct, I believe. So I'm just going to copy this. So to check if correct is in the process dot standard out, which can be for the standard output. Basically checking if the program just outputs it, then it's in the standard output, right? Now we can just do print. We'll specify F. We'll do for number found. So we'll specify curly braces for going to be for n, and it's going to be for that number. We can close it out. Now we can print out the process std out. We can just break out of that function. So here we do have a while true loop. We just create a random.runInt from 1 to 1 million. That's going to be basically the numbers, right? We need to create a process to process that run that program, take the input and also the text and also the capture underscore output. So we can set that to true. I believe we can, I'm not sure about this. I think we should set it to true since we do want the password, right? We do want to capture the output. If correct is in, we'd set this to true because of this, right? Because if correct is in that std output, which is going to be for the standard output, we can print the found number. It's going to find the number. We can also print out the process output, right? And lastly, we can just break out the function. So do chmod. We'll do plus x for run. I'm just going to run a Python 3 for run. Maybe if we're going to capitalize this. Also need to specify the program name, actually. So we know the program name. should be the last thing we need to specify. So do Python 3 for run.py. So now we do have this run.py, which does guess the sequence of numbers. So it does from 1 to 1 million. And does it use that random int, which is going to be that random.randint from 1 to 1 million. The downside with this is that we don't know if it's going to hit the number, since it is generating a bunch of numbers and just printing it out to like the... it's basically just like piping it out to bash, right? Just printing it out. If it does guess it, then it's going to print out the number found. We also don't know the approximate time this is going to take. So this can take around like 3 minutes. But it's using process output. It is generating pretty fast, right? Doing this, we can just wait and see if we do get a number. So after a while, we did find the number found, which is 767,230. In reality, this took around 11 minutes to actually find the number. I actually had to re-record this because there was like music, there was sound playing through the mic. So I re-recorded this. But yeah, this took around 11 minutes to actually find this number, 767,000, because it does generate a random function. So it's not going to, if you do run this the second time, it's not going to be the same number, right? So if I run this for test, it's not the same number. So it does use the rand function to actually generate a random number every time you do run it. So I'm just going to copy this and put this into my text editor. So I'll put this under here. Now we do have the password here. So I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to switch these to purple. Put this in here, cd back, we do id, and now we're under purple. So I'm going to start by running a sudo myself. Here we do have this attack dirty.sh, so I'm going to cat this out. We do have this user binkcurl, which is going to this master ddos hack my VM against this attack.sh. It is piping it out, so anything that we put into .sh, it is going to pipe out to bash and just run this attack.sh. It's using minus p also for privileged mode, so we can run this as root, and now we'll get a reverse shell as root, right? So there's two ways we can start by doing this. I'm a vi2/etc/host. Here we only have a read only here. So if we did have writable permissions to this host file and put the host name for this, put this host name for masterd.hackmyvm. Hack my VM. In this case, if I do run a sudo myself and try to run this as root, so if I do sudo minus u, run this as root, it's gonna not resolve the host right for this masterd.hackmyvm. Hack my VM. So we do need to do R spoofing and also DNS spoofing. So I'll do Control Shift O. I'm gonna run a bettercap. So I'm just gonna zoom in, run a bettercap against this. And here we do a bettercap. So I'm gonna run a help command. Help command just so gives us all the modules here, right? So I'll start with arp spoof. So if I do run an arp spoof, you'll see that I do have this arp spoof full duplex. Here we can specify both targets are for the gateway will be attacked. We do want to set this to true, so we'll set this to true. Here we want to do the R spoof internal. Local connections from on computers from the network will be spoofed. We don't want that. We do want R spoof targets, which is going to be for 10.0.0.134, right? 10.0.0.134. Also do need the DNS spoof, so we can run the help against this module. And here we do have the DNS spoof address. IP address to map out the domains to. So we'll do DNS spoof address to 10.0.0.070, which is going to be this Kali machine. We want to do set this to true. DNS spoof domains. So this is going to be comma separated values by of domains, domain names to spoof. So here we do have the domain name for master DDoS hack my VM. And we don't need TTL for spoof DNS replies. Looking back up, I do want to start up, we'll start up our spoof. So we can do our spoof on. We can do DNS spoof. Set this to on. You'll notice that master DDoS, anything that is going to master DDoS on my network is going to go to 10.0.70. Just to confirm this, that we did not do this right, now we can just do ping. I'll do ping minus C if it count for 3. And you see we can ping it now, right? We can also do this by, I'll run a sudo myself. I just want to see if this does work. If I run a mmap on 10.0.0.70, I don't have port 80 open, right? So I can start Python server. So do Python 3 minus m http.server from port 80. Since it doesn't have a specific port, it doesn't have a specific port for this master DDoS, so it's going to basically... it's going on port 80, right, by default. So copy this, we'll do sudo minus u, run this as root, and it did get that, you see that this gets this attack.sh. So So I'm a VI to attack DOS H. I'll go into reactor mode, we'll run up /bin/bash. I'm just gonna be getting a reverse shell here. So I'll just go to pen test monkey. I'll just go to pen test monkey for a reverse shell. We'll do for temp. Put this in here. For, do you have this for 10,070? Put this on 9,001. Right quit. Now we do this attack dot stage. Now we can start a Python server. I'll start with my listener. So do all rev, netcat, minus LVP on 9,001. Screw this one more time. We do ID. Now we're to root. So I can run a bash minus I. CD back. Dallas Mosley and cataroo.txt. Well, guys, pretty much in the video. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.